All right, so this is the Framework laptop, and it's arguably one of the coolest laptops I've ever seen in the studio. What makes it special is the fact that it's modular. It's upgradable, it's repairable, it's got a lot of kind of tweaking you can do to it in terms of the hardware front that other devices just can't do. Now, the truth is, when they first announced this product earlier this year, I think it was like February, I had my reservations. There was a part of me that was interested, but the thing is with modular tech, we've seen so many companies try and then end up failing at it. And we've seen so many projects and products just come out and then the company pulls the plug a few years later because it's tough to do. It sounds really cool on paper, but the practicality of it is limited, right? And because I had my reservations, I wasn't even sure if I was gonna do this video. I was like, maybe we'll see. But I got it in and I was like, okay, this is something special. So there's two perspectives I have about this thing. So the first is from the mind of a tech enthusiast. This is really cool. It's everything that a laptop enthusiast would want in a device, right? The ability to just upgrade and repair and fix anything that you want in this device, like from the screen to the keyboard, everything can be removed and replaced as you see fit, which I love, especially with the whole right to repair stuff and like it's got a cool logo. There's a lot to like about this, but there's another part of me that's thinking about this product from the perspective of like, of business. How viable is something like this actually? Like if all those big companies out there have tried and seemingly failed at trying to deliver something like this, akin to this, how successful can this product be? And there's just a conversation to be had. So this laptop starts at $750, but that's just for a do-it-yourself base model. If you configure it to a reasonable configuration with 16 gigs of RAM and maybe 500 gigs of storage, you're looking at around $1,000. It's not cheap, but there's clearly a price premium for something like this versus a regular laptop, right? That isn't modular and isn't as repairable. Now, in that price point of around $1,000, you have to pick up, or you are recommended to pick up, these modules. And the modules are these accessories that slot into the four available sockets that are built into this device. And you plug them up, they just slide right in and it becomes this new functional port. Now, there's a whole bunch of different modules you can get. There's USB-A connections, USB-C, there's micro SD. There isn't like a big boy SD card. I'm not sure if that's something that's gonna come down the line, but that was kind of missing. But the pricing on these seems very fair. Like they start at $9 and I imagine a lot of other companies that would build a modular device like this would charge a lot more for these little accessories. Now they connect via USB 4, but there is no support for Thunderbolt right now. The hardware is capable of it. It's just not certified. So the official compatibility is not there yet, but in the future, it is theoretically possible that this could support an external GPU via the Thunderbolt connection. But this system of modules allows this device to be very versatile. You can load out your laptop however which way you want it, right? If you have ports that you want, put them in. If there's ports you never use, like say you never use a display out ever, you just now have a laptop that doesn't have that in its port selection, which is really cool. Now, I think some people looking at this are like, how is that useful? How is that, I guess, different or better than an existing system? And you could just, you could plug up a dongle to it and you have all that stuff. The whole idea is that you don't have to have dongles. You don't need any of that stuff. You don't even need to have like an external drive. Like you can just plug it up. I just realized this. There's a USB-C drive, like this thing. It's a USB-C drive, it's a flash drive. I could connect this to my camera, record off of it, and then when I'm done, I'm just like, it slots right into the computer. And that's, there you have it, over USB-C 4. That's pretty cool. Now, the build quality of this device is good for what you're getting. Like for a device that's as disassemblable, is that even a word? As disassemblable as this is, it's good. But if you compare it to stuff like any of these, right? So this is like the Surface laptop and a XPS 13 and a MacBook. All three of these devices are very well built and they're thinner and they're sturdier than this. The Framework laptop is good, but there are some deficiencies. Like the big one to me is the screen. Like there's just a little bit more flex than I would like to see. It's expected, but it's just there. And also the hinge, there's this spring-like characteristic to it that I'm not sure where it's coming from. Like I popped it open, you'll see in a second, but it's not obvious as to why it does this, but there's just more wobble to the screen than I'd like. And I am slightly concerned about the hinge for long-term durability. But overall, the build quality is good. But the things you have to keep in mind, This is assembled with screws and magnets, lots of screws and lots of magnets, whereas these are adhesives, right? These are just gonna stick and just have more rigidity to it, but you just can't repair it and you can't open. Like the Surface laptop in particular is very difficult to get into, but that's the price you have to pay. If you want modularity and openability, I'm making up words all over this video, but if you want that, you can't have adhesives, right? You have to have screws and magnets, and it's just, I think this is just the nature of a product that is as upgradable and repairable as this is. But I like this, right? The thing is, if you're looking at this from the perspective of a product you can completely disassemble, it's quite good. So I wanna show you the insides, and to get in here, you have to remove five screws or unscrew five of them, but they're captive. There's like clips that hold them in, so you can't ever lose them, which is nice to see. And then it doesn't actually open from the bottom, like most laptops. You have to go in from the top, the keyboard comes off, so it's attached magnetically, which is cool, and then you don't just yank it off because there's a cable you have to disconnect. It's this thing, there's a pull tab, and you yank it, and you're good to go. Now, another thing that I thought was really cool, I have busted several laptops in the past through this type of disassembly, where I've pulled off the keyboard, and I yanked a little bit too aggressively, too enthusiastically, and I ripped the cable, or just like tore it a little bit. They've reinforced this cable so that I think this could withstand a ton of yanking pressure. So I don't feel like most people that are popping this open will actually damage it. This is really important because this cable, you rip it, it's a bummer. And I've done it a bunch. Okay, so inside we are looking at a very cool system. So where do we begin? So first of all, you can tell that the people behind this project care about the internals. There's a note from the framework team. There's QR codes, you can scan them so you can pull up a repair guide or to get replacement parts. There's spare screws in case you lose one. And all of the components in here are upgradable and replaceable, including the motherboard, which houses the CPU. So you can't swap out the CPU, you can't do like a chip drop, which would be amazing on a laptop, but you could swap out the motherboard, and apparently you can use this, like the kind of central processing area, as a separate computer. Like you can plug it up to power and you can run a device, like, you know, if you're technologically savvy, you can use that component and power a TV or build a system off of just that motherboard, which is super cool. You also have your two RAM slots, your NVMe drive, as well as your Wi-Fi slot, and all of that stuff is replaceable and upgradable as you deem necessary, as well as the battery that can come out and you can replace it over time. But that's not new. I don't think any of these components are special in the sense that many other laptops also allow that. Now this battery is a 55 watt hour battery. I got 8.5 hours on my regular testing. But what is really cool is the bezel of the screen. So this is attached via magnets. And I think the magnet element of it is one of the reasons why it is less like rigid compared to other devices. But how many times have you ever seen a bezel of a laptop be removed? It's pretty cool, like easily. Normally you have to peel and pry and get hair dryers to loosen up the adhesive. This is so much easier, and you can access and replace the panel or upgrade it down the line. Now this panel has a glossy surface, but it's not a touch sensitive screen. It's a nice aspect ratio, 3:2. And you also have a like a kill switch on the panel. Like, look how easy it is to put it back on. Come on, dude, how cool is that? Oh, I didn't put it on properly. But, right? It's so quick to put the bezel back on. But there's a kill switch, right? If you have privacy concerns, you could flick it, kill the mic, kill the camera, and you are supposedly secure. But this is a feature I've never seen before. It's like magnet on a bezel. It's awesome. Now, the screen itself, if I'm being honest, I don't love the screen. Like, the resolution is good, the aspect ratio is good, but there's a good amount of ghosting. If you're playing games on this or viewing any kind of content that has a lot of motion in it, that ghosting might bother you, but the screen is otherwise good. It's just that at this kind of price point, there's so many other competitor products that have really good screens, like truly excellent screens. So this just feels like it's slightly below average if I'm kind of reviewing the screen. So I'm just gonna close this up real quick, and then I wanna move on to performance. Actually, before we get into performance, I wanna show you something on the keyboard that I thought was interesting. So, if you look at the keyboard, there are a ridiculous number of screws on it. Like, we're talking, I didn't disassemble it, but my guess is like 50 screws, maybe more. Like, there's a lot of screws on here. And the assembly time for this has to be high, right? If you think about a regular keyboard that uses adhesives, right? It's like, puts it on, and then the machine just puts, right? It's so much quicker. This, if it's not labor time, it's machine time. And this has to jack up the price of this product. Just the existence of all the screws to be able to keep that keyboard removable. Okay, so to assemble this back up, it's one cable, that ribbon cable you saw earlier, and you place the keyboard back into position, and then the magnets will do the work. It's very quick. Now the keyboard itself is nice. I like the layout. It's got a good amount of travel. The up down arrows might be a little small for some users, but I think most people will like this keyboard quickly. The trackpad's also pretty good. It's a glass surface with solid click mechanics. So performance, it's good, but the fans are a little bit louder at the top end than I would have expected, because this is not like a super thin device, right? It's thin, but if you compare it to something like an XPS 13, this is a very thin device. You put them side by side, the XPS 13 is like, I don't know, probably 15% thinner. It's got the same kind of performance output, but the XPS 13 is quieter. And if you compare it to, let's say, like a Razer Blade Stealth. So this is a device that is, I mean, this is of the same kind of thickness, I believe, as the framework. Actually, the framework is a little bit thicker, but the Stealth has a GTX 1650 in it, right? It's got a discrete GPU, and this is the price you have to pay when it comes to upgradeability, modularity, repairability, openability. It has to have extra thickness to compensate for all the, right? All the screws and magnets that you have to have access to for the user. I like it, I really like it, but not everyone's gonna be in the same boat. A lot of people are gonna prefer the kind of thinner form factor you can get when you're using adhesives and don't have the openability, to use that word again. Okay, I'm gonna talk about pricing, because that's a very big part of this conversation. The framework laptop to me is about 10, maybe 15% more expensive than a product that doesn't have the upgradeability and repairability. So I wouldn't compare it to like the premium stuff. I'd compare it to like Acer and Asus. Like those devices are of this ilk in terms of the build quality. And it's about 15% more expensive. And I think it's fair, right? At this kind of price point, I do think that it's fair, because you are getting all the kind of advantages that you get with framework. But I don't think that pricing is sustainable. Like, in order for this company to exist down the line and not just disappear after a couple years, this has to be profitable for them. And at this kind of pricing, I don't think that they're getting the volume. They're not selling the number of units they would need to for this to sustain that business. And that worries me. Like, if you think about it, the people that are interested in this device right now are probably, you know, the guys on PC Master Race. They're the people that are sweaty about laptops and they love this stuff. I love this stuff, but we're not everybody. Most people are not even comfortable swapping out a drive on a laptop, let alone swapping out a CPU, right? Most people would way rather pay for the convenience and simplicity and durability of a non-repairable laptop than to go for this. Right? That's, I want to say it's like 99% of people would prefer that stuff over this in terms of laptop buyers. Now, I bought one despite knowing the fact that there's a very real possibility that this company could disappear in 2-3 years' time. It's in the realm of possibilities that they go bankrupt, right? I don't want them to. I super don't want them to, but it is possible. I will say they do have one advantage over all the companies that we've seen try modular stuff before. The difference being that when it comes to like Google, with Project Era, or the Motorola modular phones, or Lenovo, or even Alienware, when they did the modular thing with the Area 51. I think that for all of those companies, these modular things were like a side project. There was like this experimental thing they were trying to do, and they're like, let's see if modular stuff is cool, if it can catch on. If it does, great, but if it doesn't, we axe it. If it's not profitable, we axe it, right? That's the regular company. With Framework, they're like, this is what they're founded on. They're all in on the idea of modularity. And when you have conviction like that, when you believe in a product like that and there's like no other option, you just, right? The community can sense it as a reviewer, like you can smell it. These guys, they give a shit. They really give a shit with this product because you can just tell that they believe in it. And when they believe in it, it's easier for the consumers to be on board. Okay, I'm gonna close off this video with this one thought. As why do I care about this? Why do I want Framework to succeed? It's because they've sponsored this. No, it's because this product is like, okay, it's not this product that I want. this is not like the end goal, right? What I want to see is gaming laptops have modularity. Because if you think about one of the reasons why people always rip on laptops is that you can't upgrade them, right? You, with a desktop, with a gaming desktop, you can have a 4 or 5 year old CPU, slap in a new GPU, and it's like, it's a whole new experience. You can play games and see stuff that you've never seen before, right? You can't do that with laptops. You want a new GPU? You gotta buy a whole new everything, including a super expensive new CPU. And I hate that, right? This, I mean, Framework can't do it right now, but this is the line. It's the path to that. Maybe one day AMD, NVIDIA, Intel, they make these like standardized GPUs you can stick into your laptop. That would be sick. Maybe this is the beginning. Okay. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thumbs if you liked it, subs if you loved it. See you guys next time.